not to stop it because it just amused me so.
Well, I suppose that's part of the fun there is.
I'm a dick.
That's good. That's good.
All right. Well, looks like we've got a lot more friendlies going on right now in the PM area. That's pretty fun to watch.
That's very good. That's one thing that really like. What time is it? Hold on.
It's a time.
We have. Oh, Matt texted me. What's up, Brad? You at the tournament thing? I'm totally at the tournament thing.
2:39.
My training partner actually texted me.
How does that phone still work?
How's this phone too? Oh, you're right. This is dummy phone. 2.0, man.
That is a 1.0.
1.0.
Only right. 11 characters.
Oh, it's beautiful. I'm never going to upgrade unless it just like poops out. All right.
I got this one, smartphone for free, so I can't even.
It's admirable. Okay, so I'm going to try to focus on this match.
So Ripple just decides to, ooh, right off the bat, destroy Ganondorf's life.
Very, very optimal choice there. Ganon has very difficult.
And then Pooch on the other side tries to just destroy Luigi's life.
Wow, he escorted a Luigi? That's very impressive.
Like I said, Samus' floatiness really helps her out like in almost all situations.
That's
true. And that Nair. Just day-to-day's Nair will stop so much. And why did you jump out of shield?
I don't agree with that.
That was way after.
Okay. So a nice, DG's down.
Dies, and that, Kit gets hit, but he ain't dead. I guess we're gonna see the new age talk shit get hit. Get Kit. All right, so this is the first, Ganondorf that hasn't immediately lost all of his stock, so that's kind of nice to see. shout outs to every other Ganon that I've said that has been losing all their stocks.
Okay.
I mean nothing by it. You played really good players.
Well, that's a fairly like predominant weakness that Ganon has is like his ability to like recover.
Yeah. I don't know. I think a lot of Ganons aren't really using Dead Man's Volley the way they should to defend themselves because
you can
when you're floating out there and someone comes at you, just use your actual cape. Don't try to interrupt it with a move. Use your cape.
You can also be reverse it to where you're like face away from people and have the back air. Yep.
That's what I love doing.
Exactly.
That's actually my number one approach option. I'm like,
yeah, I've started using that recently, actually.
Yep. Short hop, immediate bat.
Ooh! See, that's the thing. Back air, very underutilized by Ganons, I feel like. And it's I don't know, it's not as utilized as it should be because
Jesus, Pooch! Stop hitting him!
What is he doing?
You've only hit your partner, Pooch!
Pooch, please! Oh, I love Pooch. Please.
God damn it, Ripple, why aren't you double Samus?
Why is he going why does he have the Wario tag?
He's had it for a while.
Oh, he has, hasn't he?
And there goes the Ganondorf losing all of his stocks. And taking his Luigi partner's last stock. Shoutouts to Sovereign for losing all the stocks.
Is he making fun of me? I feel like he's making fun of me.
Which one?
Pooch with the warrior tag.
Probably.
Bastard.
Pooch just being like, nah, I'm good at this game now. Pooch probably seen the most improvement in play that I've seen since Shuffle 7, I think?
Well, I mean, he's a melee player, right?
Huh?
He's a melee player, right?
Pooch?
Yeah.
I mean, he plays melee.
Is he predominantly PM player?
I would say he's 50-50, but I think he's more PM than he is melee. I'd say he's a lot more melee at PM than he is melee, but he plays both at the same time all the time.
Oh, okay. I thought he came from melee and then went to PM.
He could have, but from what I know, he really likes PM.
That's good.
Yeah, he's a melee player who loves PM.
That's good, that's good.
So he's a bolt. He's a smash player.
Okay. I was kind of worried that he was going off his melee skill and kind of disrespecting PM and just like going in there.
Nope. Pooch loves himself some PM.
Very good.
Because it gives him a lot more room to talk shit.
Yes.
Not sure if he can stare on stream actually.
I just love Pooch. Like I want more.
Pooch's commentary is the single worst and best there is.
Really? I've actually never heard his commentary.
He is just rude. He goes in on everyone. Like, you think I've been calling people out. You should listen to Pooch.
I don't think you've really been calling out people.
I've totally counted out people, and then for all the wrong reasons, because it turns out that no, you're calling out the wrong person.
Well, you know what? You've been respectable, and, like, you've been, like, it's like, okay, this is what they're doing wrong, and, like, but at the same time, it's like, okay, I'll note what they're doing right.
The thing is, like, this... the thing with this is a lot of these Ganons, they are not playing a...
optimally.
Yeah. They're all playing aggressive when Ganon needs to be playing a lot more reactive.
Yeah.
Like right
spacing.
There, unfortunately, Kit needed to go out there. Like, look at the tools that your Ganondorf is having to defend against. You needed to get in there and interrupt that day-to-day.
Exactly.
Because that day-to-day, his eyesight was all on that Ganon. Just like, oh, if I just do right here, I can look at this Ganondorf, look like I'm like ready to fair him, and then just slowly back air.
Yep.
End game.
But Ganon excels at, like, staying on the stage right here, putting out hitboxes, spacing out, being patient.
Right now, this Sovereign would do really well just to learn shield drops out of platforms.
Ooh,
shield drop off air would have saved his life a couple. Like, it saved a lot of percent at this point.
I feel like a lot of PM players need to implement shield drops.
You know what a lot of PM players need to start implementing that I've been working on, trying to work on the last 2 days?
Instant
aerial glide toss.
Ah, very.
That is when when someone like Diddy uses his peanut bop gun,
yeah,
air dodge into even off stage, air dodge into the peanut to pick it up, and then immediately aerial glide toss. You can do that.
Ah.
So in one fluid motion, all you've done is give yourself an extra jump when someone is trying to gimp you with a peanut.
I see.
You got it, huh?
I was about to say that makes sense.
No, I thought someone yelled my name.
No. You're fine.
But it's one of my favorite things to see. And I see Junebug over there. He might have been the one yelling at me. I've only played Junebug once, and that was in a crew battle.
I need to play Junebug and Ganondorf.
My match against Junebug and the crew battle actually went really well for me. It was back in 3.0. I believe it was. I believe the crew battle was Coney, Junebug, and I can't remember the third person on their team. But our team was Anther, Lordy, and myself.
Ooh, okay.
And I was tired and wanted to be on point. And I went on point, and I two-stocked Coney, I believe.
Uh-huh.
And then I nearly took three stocks of Junebug before he took my two. But
ooh.
I just could not get that other stock out. And then Lordy came in and took one stock. he might have gotten two stocks, actually.
Fairly.
But Anther could not take on Junebug, and I can't remember the last player. But Junebug ripped Lordy anyway. It was fun to watch until I lost $5.
Indeed.
MVP right here.
Sorry to detract from the current conversation, but we got a match here.
This is really interesting, but Pooch is... Ooh, nope. Oh, he did. This is actually a possible matchup now.
This is a very, very close match right now. Anything can happen, honestly, depending on how...
There it is. Using that cape. Using your Ooh, partner to attack.
Nice! And the Falcon is done. Now it's all on Ganon's ability to kill.
Get ready to use your cape. Get ready to use your cape.
The cape is not as important as the float.
Don't just throw it out. And you're dead.
You're done. No. Ganon lives forever.
No.
Nice float. Oh!
What?
Yo! The gimp!
Oh, boy.
All right, all right.
Go for it,
Mopper. Oh, my goodness.
You are God. You are God! Pooch is the Red Bull all over the table.
Oh, my goodness. I got so hyped, I knocked
Pooch's Red Bull over.
I knocked your Red Bull. That was your Red Bull, right? No, yours is yellow.
Yep.
I knocked somebody's Red Bull over. I am sorry. I apologize to the stream for, like, going crazy, but that was ridiculous.
Oh, my God.
Thor.
What's up, buddy? Highlight reel.
All right, so we got a Giphy Cat there. We just had to go in. We had to go more in. Sovereign's a god. Sovereign is my sovereign. And here we go. So Ripple has a love for this stage. And honestly, I believe that this is a really good decision at his point. But Kit's Captain Falcon is kind of... Oh, there we go. I think Sovereign actually plays against Ripple fairly well. He really needs to get over to him, though, because you cannot leave your partner alone with Ripple, okay? He does naughty things to you. Like, it needs to be Sovereign versus day-to-day, Ripple's day-to-day, and Kit versus Samus, because I believe that will give them the best shot. But honestly, you can't really talk about 1v1 scenarios in these matches.
Okay, back in there.
Whoa! Pooch deciding, hey, you're out. One side to another. From one corner to another, uh-huh.
Okay, so they're taking this a little more seriously.
Yep.
Green team's down two stocks. In comparison to blue team's one stock.
Yep, but you know, it's all about those dares.
Who let them take them here? That was a terrible decision.
This is their favorite stage. I mean, hey, they took us here, and we beat them here.
Did you honestly beat Pooch and Ripple here?
Yeah, LTC3.
Really? That's extremely impressive, because GTD and Samus do fairly extremely well right here.
Yeah, but so does Squirtle and Sonic.
That's true. I forgot. Your team.
Our team countered their team as far as when it came to this counter pick.
That's really interesting.
But looks like Ripple and Pooch are just like, this is our stage today.
Yeah.
I cannot believe that down smash killed. It had the worst DI in the world.
Didn't really expect it, I suppose.
It shield poked, so, you know, it's unfortunate for him. But Ganon needs to tilt his shield. I think he's one of the characters that needs the most to tilt his shield. Where Sovereign was not in that life.
Ooh, the pickup from Captain.
Oh, yeah.
The double pickup. My goodness.
Sovereign needs to keep his last self alive. Kit needs to be all up in them. Oh, you've got to save your partner. Don't run away. Save your partner.
Stay alive. Please stay alive.
The number one thing people forget in teams is your partner's life is more important than getting the kill.
Exactly.
Unless it's literally their last stock. Yeah. You're saving your partner. Oh, you did not get your wall drop.
Well, see, here's the practice. I always like.
Well, you know, it happened last time. Sovereign, just take the stat. You know you can. You already did before.
Well, the thing is, you always have to consider it. You have four stocks, and the last one is the only one that matters. You have three extra lives to play with.
Yeah.
So
the game doesn't end until all the stocks are gone.
Exactly. So your game doesn't end until you're done.
Oh, come on, Sovereign. Everyone saw that coming.
So we have...
That was kindergarten reading level. Come on.
So if you're smart enough, if you play the game, you don't need those three stars.
I do love it when someone uses three.
Oh! My goodness gracious.
It's done.
Oh. It froze.
Let's just hit our partner and it's done.
It's done.